this is cool. It's like a little mirror. I can see what my dress is doing.
Hey everybody, it's Cindy Matalucci with the Pulse of San Diego. Thank you so much for tuning into our live show today. We have an amazing show. I want to thank Andre Soriano for my fabulous dress today. Thank you so much. You are a guru. Thank you for providing this dress. So I want to talk about my amazing guest today. I am so humbled and honored to have Marina Donahue, director, writer, producer of her first feature film, All in Time, which is screening December 8th at Landmark Cinemas in Hillcrest. We're going to talk a little bit about that, but I'm so happy to have you today.
Oh my gosh, Cindy, it's so great to be here, and it's so nice to see you again.
I know. So
it's really great.
So for those of you who don't know, the two of us met at La Costa Film Festival 2 years ago. Ruby Callahan, we can thank her for that.
Thank you, Ruby.
She introduced us, and her film actually was the opening night debut film at the La Costa Film Festival. So we got to meet. That was 2 years ago. So before we get into talking about your amazing film, I want to talk about your story. Because you are a San Diego native.
Yeah.
I know you went to UCSD alumni.
I did.
So you're back in San Diego. But I want to know, did you always know you wanted to be a filmmaker?
No, I didn't. Definitely something that kind of grew. At UCSD, I studied history. And I was always interested in history. But now when I think about it, it's very similar to film in that it's telling stories. And so I love a good story. And that's what filmmaking is trying to tell a good story. So I think I came by it naturally. I might have been doing my homework my whole life. But no, it wasn't until later. I was always interested in film, and my parents, they brought me to the movies every Friday night. My parents came to divorce. My mom kept up the tradition, and we would always go to the movies, and I have such fond memories of being in a theater with my parents. And actually, that's my happy place, is being in a movie theater. I love it. And as I got older, I became more and more interested in how the movies were made. And then, you know, sometimes you would stumble upon a movie set, and you would be around the barricade, and you would look in, and I would go, oh my gosh, what do all those people do? I want to know what every single person does. And so then I became more and more interested in it. And then, luckily, my daughter ended up being very talented in singing, dancing, and acting, and she started getting parts in movies, and I would go to set with her, and again, that sense of wonder would just take over, and I would find somebody on the crew and say, can you tell me who everybody is and what they all do? And I just kind of got the bug, and eventually started meeting people through her, and put the word out that I wanted to get more involved in a movie, and I did. So, and that's how this happened. So, it's, yeah, just very, very fortunate how it all happened.
That's so exciting. Well, okay, so in 2009, you teamed with Chris Fetchko to develop and produce All in Time. Prior to that, you worked in documentary development for National Geographic Television. You currently run Corner Bar Pictures, which is very impressive. I know you're co-producing a web series and two short films. So you have an amazing resume. I've been following you for the last 2 years. I know you've got a lot of stuff going on.
I've been following you too.
We've been following each other.
Yeah, a little bit of mutual admiration society going on here.
Girl power.
That's right.
But I want to talk about the film, because I was blown away by the film when I saw it. It's spectacular. So for the viewers, I mean, tell them a little bit about the film.
It's about following your dream, really. It's about leaving a steady and predictable life to go after a dream at all costs. And we follow a guy named Charlie who quits his job in New York to move home to Pennsylvania and follow his dream of managing his hometown rock and roll band. But at the heart of it is a love story between Charlie and his gorgeous girlfriend, played beautifully by Vanessa Ray, and how their relationship is affected by Charlie's roller coaster ride that is following a dream. And so we get to see how she reacts to a lot of the craziness that is going on, and we have a big twist also that comes about three quarters of the way through the film, which is kind of takes the audience on their own wild ride. It's got great music. It's very inspiring. And it's been doing really well. We've won 12 awards on the film festival circuit, so we're really proud about that. And
well, the cast is amazing. I mean, yes. Lynn Cohen, love her role. She was like perfect. She is sassy, by the way. I got to interview her at La Costa, and I just thought, wow, that woman has so much sass.
She does. Oh, yeah. And on set, oh, my gosh, she's a pistol. She was really fun. We actually ended up creating a blooper roll of all of her outtakes because she tends to go for very colorful language. So in the movie, she's presented as a very sweet, she plays this next door neighbor to Charlie who kind of comes off at first as a little bit nosy, but then you realize she's got a huge heart and is really looking after him. And, but yeah, she's got, she's a fiery, wonderful personality. And a lot of fun, and she's really the heart and soul of our film. And I think we're going to see a clip of her, right?
We are. It's coming up. Well, and before we get to that, I wanted to ask you, because the film is based on your partner Chris Fetchko's life.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to know, I mean, really, Charlie is Chris.
That's right.
So it's like, how did that play into the dynamic of the film?
Right. Well, it was really fun. So Chris really did quit his job in New York City to move home to Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania, to manage this band that he had loved for years. And he really did ended up telling his girlfriend at the time that he loved the band more than her. And so that kind of was the seed for, you know, an inkling of a story that he had in mind that he wanted to tell, because he went on to success and was in a packed concert hall, but he felt empty because he didn't have the girl. And he's like, there's a movie in here somewhere. So those were the basic tenets of the movie. And then, you know, we dramatized a lot of other things, brought a lot of other stuff to make it more cinematic. But yeah, and what's really cool is that the band that he quit his job for is the band whose music we use in the film. And,
right, the Badleys are the damsels.
The Badleys, exactly. They're great. They're out of Pennsylvania. They're really good. You know, a lot of people dedicate their lives in the music business, dedicate their lives to having a band heard. And that's what Chris did for this band. And it's so cool now because our soundtrack is selling like hotcakes. And so it's like
awesome.
His love for the band is really being realized and appreciated now. So it's great. But two of the band members from the Badleys actually play the lead singer and the drummer in The Damsels, which is the fictional name of the band that we have in the film. So the music's very authentic. We recorded the music live in the places where we shot, so it sounds really good. It's not like a Disney pre-recorded studio track stuff. It's very, very authentic.
Well, and Laura Shea blew me away.
Oh, yeah.
She had like four She's original amazing. Songs, I mm-hmm. think, in the movie. She was amazing. I mean, the soundtrack itself is insane.
Yeah.
So it's another character.
Laura is a jewel. She's also out of Pennsylvania. And when she hits the screen, people just lose it. She's just absolutely gorgeous, and her voice is like silk. It's just, and so talented as a songwriter, too. Just. And her music just fits the story so well, too. We were able to pick some of her songs that actually move the storyline along, and they really get you. We're very lucky to have her as well in the film.
Well, we're going to show you an exclusive clip right now, so take a look at this.
Come on, Charlie, don't make me pound all day. I got arthritis.
Connor.
Come on, Charlie, open the damn
door. What do you want?
Hi. I made a little something for you. It's really good, yeah.
I really appreciate the food, Mrs. Joshman, but I just want to go back to sleep. Okay? Thank you.
Hey!
Charlie. Oh, come on. Come on, please. I just go back to bed.
God!
Don't judge.
Charlie. Get up and pull yourself together.
Why? What's the freaking point, Mrs. J?
I promise you it's all going to work out one way or another.
If
you just get off the couch. Jesus!
Oh.
It's starting to rot. The whole damn place is stinking.
Oh. I love that clip.
She's so funny. When she walks out the door and goes, tss. I mean, we're like, what is that? But it's the cutest thing. She's really fun.
What is it about that clip that you love?
Well, I think it's the part where in the movie where you really realize how much she cares about this guy. And also, I'm sure you kind of agree, you might agree that sometimes it takes a woman to get a man off his ass and get back to work and get back to life. And so she plays that role beautifully for Charlie in this scene. So I love that for that.
Okay, so we have to talk a little bit before we get to the screening. We have to talk about the struggle, because I don't think people realize that there was so much that went into getting this movie out there for you. Mm-hmm. 2009 you started. I know that there was 2 years of writing, raising money. I know you had to fix and re-edit. Mm-hmm. There was a lot going on. You and Chris lived in 2 different places. I mean, talk to us a little bit about bringing this to fruition.
Yeah, we did. So Chris and I were about 2 hours apart. So we would travel back and forth. Most of the time he came to my house and we would set up camp at the kitchen table and just throw ideas back and forth and write. And what was really neat was, since it's a collaboration between a man and a woman, we were able to put our personal experiences for each gender and our relationship memories and how we felt at different times. So into the writing, and we allowed each other that that trust that, okay, that's how guys think and that's what they would say, and he goes, yeah, and I'd say, okay, well, this is how girls would react to that, and this is what they would say, and this is something similar happened to me, and this is how I felt. And so I was able to bring that to Rachel's character, and so the result is that both men and women are equally moved by the film and the writing, and they feel that we've written for them. So it's not like a guy trying to write for a girl's part, imagining what's in her mind. And so I think that's kind of unique about our collaboration, which is really nice. But yeah, Chris and I fought like cats and dogs. We really did. There were a lot of other times when we did not agree and we did not trust each other. But Chris likes to say that we're both really, really passionate about this film, and that's why it's here, because neither one of us ever gave up. But when you have two very passionate people, you know, it can clash at times.
Oh, we know how that is.
So it did take some time, and I was also, this is my first film, and I had a lot to learn along the journey. So a lot of it was just a learning curve, being on set and making a lot of mistakes. But, you know, luckily time is forgiving, and if you just keep at it and you never give up, eventually, you know, you can realize your dream. So it's, our movie is about following a dream, but for Chris and I, we followed a dream to make this movie. And so we edited, it didn't work. We tested the film back in 2012. And it didn't work, and so for 2 years we kind of went back and forth on how to fix it, and we finally, there was a point where we had just almost completely given up, and it looked like the film was never going to get made. And so I think we were talking about this earlier, that there was going to be a lot of money to fix the film, and it was going to be somewhere between $200,000 and $400,000 money that we needed to shoot some new scenes and fix some scenes. And a guy came in, again, like this venture capitalist filmmaker. He thought that he would be able to help finish the film.
But he didn't want you to be involved or something,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he wanted to split us up. He said that the reason why things were taking so long with this film is because there were two creative people. And he said, I'll come in with the money, but Chris is going to be on set and is going to be the director, and Marina's going to be banned from the set, and she can't come to set, and she can't come to the editing room. And in fact, I'll hire a security guard to to keep her out. And Chris said, absolutely not. You know, even though Chris and I were fighting at the time, he's like, no, that's not right. And that really brought Chris and I back together. And like, I was so thankful to him. And so we came together and we finished the script. We hired a new editor. We shot new scenes. And then we got into tons of film festivals and won 12 awards. So it all worked out.
It's so amazing. And I just wanted the viewers to know that, because people think, oh, it's a movie and it's great and it's so easy. But you have come through so much. And this is your first movie, and it's not always easy. But look at it. And the reviews, okay, we have to get to the reviews, are amazing. All in Time Rock, said the LA Times. The Hollywood Reporter, smart and clever, convincing, unpredictable. So you've had amazing reviews of this movie.
Okay, yeah.
I think it's anyone, you guys, you have to see it. So let's tell everybody where to see it, because you are screening the film in Hillcrest mm-hmm. on December 8th.
On December 8th, yep, at the Landmark Hillcrest Theater at 7 o'clock. You can go to our website, which is allintimefilm.com, to our screenings page, and there's a link to buy tickets there. We're also going to be in Seattle, Portland, and San Francisco between now and then. We're doing these one-night promotional events with Q&As afterwards. Chris and I will both be at all of the screenings, and we'd love for you to come. If you can't make it, we are on iTunes and Amazon and Google Play. Again, if you go to our website, there's a watch page and it has all the links to where you can watch at home. It's always better to see it in the theater, though, but if not, you can see it at home.
Well, we'll be there December 8th, so get your tickets, come out, support this film. Congratulations, Marina, on all your success. We love
Thank
it.
You. And Thank you so much.
We're so happy that we had you here today. Thanks for being here.
Thank you. Thank you, Cindy.
Thank
it's
you.
It's really fun. Thanks.
Go see the movie, allintimefilm.com.